So leading up to the election, we did a whole lot of content on Project 2025, and I invited fellow content creators to come on and talk with me about it and help me to break it down. We talked with Texas Trey, we talked with Denver Riggleman, we talked with Coach D, we talked with the Voice of Reason guys. D Knight did a whole lot of content about it. The Midas Touch Network, of course, did content about it on a daily basis. We tried to bring the receipts and the evidence and show people what it was that Project 2025 was all about and what it was saying. I went to the point of actually printing it off and reading it, and I had people say, even the people that I was breaking it down with was like, man, this thing is long and it's boring at times and it's kind of hard to understand at times, but there were glaring things that stood out to us that we felt like needed to be talked about, and we did. And then when people begin to catch wind of it, and suddenly even the mainstream media began to name drop it, and when people started and going reading it, I saw people in my part of the world who I know are Trump supporters and who were sharing pro-Trump stuff all the time, but they saw parts of Project 2025, and even they would say, wait a minute, I don't like what's in here. I don't like what this has to say. And so I noticed that people were starting to catch on to what Project 2025 was about. They were starting to show interest. And then Donald Trump came out, and all he had to do was say, I know nothing about it. I don't have anything to do with that. I have Agenda 47. I don't even know the people that, you know, are associated with that. So I thought the thing to do would be bring the receipts and show him shaking hands with them. Show them saying out loud that they knew he had to distance himself from it because they knew it wasn't popular. They weren't offended. They said out loud, we're not offended that he has to distance himself from us and throw us under the bus because we know that on day one, he will put it in motion. So we brought all of that evidence and we showed it to people. We broke it down. We talked about the things that were going to happen, and the things that were going to happen would affect everyone and not just people that looks like them. It's going to affect them too. They just haven't caught on to that part yet. So we brought all that evidence. We talked about it from every angle. We pointed out how that they were, you know, okay with Trump throwing them under the bus because they knew Trump would do it on day one. And now that Trump is president-elect, MAGA podcaster Matt Walsh comes out and says, well, I'm paraphrasing here, but he basically says, now we can all say out loud that Project 2025 was the plan all along. And Steve Bannon shares that, and he's laughing it up, and they're all laughing it up, saying on day one, we can't wait to be there working alongside President Trump to push all of this through. And now they're saying, hey, we knew that he had to badmouth us a little bit. We were okay with it because we knew it would help us get it in once he got in. And now that he's president-elect, they're saying out loud, yep, we can say it out loud now. We can breathe. It's okay to say it. So here's my question to my subscribers. I want to talk to you guys for a minute because if I'm being dead honest with you going forward, I'm still trying to figure out what happened, and I'm still trying to reflect on what happened, and I welcome opinions and ideas as to what happened and as to what went forward. I've got some great messages from a lot of folks saying things that really made me think, and I appreciate you for that. But my question to you would be this. If you can bring the evidence to people and you can show it to them, if you can show them videos of people behind closed doors bamboozling them, if you can show them all the things we showed them, if you can break it down and read it to them and explain it, and yet they still turn a blind eye to it, and they vote for the man that's going to put it in place, and then they'll still say, oh, it won't be that bad. How in the hell do we ever communicate with those kind of people? How can they be helped? Really, I have people that I love and care about that fell for this bullshit. If all the receipts we brought didn't work, what the hell are we supposed to do next other than sit back and watch it unfold? And as we sit back and watch it unfold and they start saying, we didn't vote for this, I really am going to hate to flex, but I'm going to have to say, yeah, you did. Yeah, you did vote for this. This is what we were trying to tell you. this is what we was trying to point out while you was saying, oh no, that's not what, Trump don't have nothing to do with that. We showed him. We showed him that he had everything to do with it. We showed him they had everything to do with him. But all he had to say was, I don't know nothing about that. I didn't have nothing to do with that. And they believe it. I'm sure right now there's people on their side of the aisle that would see a video like this and go, oh, they're not going to do that. Or if they do do that, it ain't going to be so bad. And then one day, it's going to hit them. And when it hits them, they're going to turn to us, or they probably won't turn to us because they'll always hate us for pointing it out to them, but they're going to be on social media. You're going to see videos of them going, this ain't what I voted for. What the hell's going on here? Well, once a cult leader has you in the cult and has you under his thumb and has you under his control, and once you give him unchecked power with no guardrails, he does not need you anymore. There's a lot of people saying things like, well, you know, American people have spoken. They're tired of the Democrats. The American people have spoken. They're tired of woke. The American people have spoken. They don't give a shit what celebrities think. It don't matter if Taylor Swift or Batista endorsed her. You know, people, they don't resonate with the working man. What resonated with people was they were struggling. I'll give them that all day long. They were and still are struggling, and they're going to be struggling even harder going forward, but they were struggling. And the fact that they were struggling made them so bitter and made them so angry at everything that they feared and everything they didn't understand, that they didn't care what happened to the people they feared or the people they didn't understand. And yes, the church played a massive role into this and has my entire life. They've played a massive role in convincing people that Democrats are the devil and that at least they ain't a Democrat. See, I live here in Blood Red, Tennessee. Marsha Blackburn won re-election. It was devastating because we needed Gloria Johnson. I have met Gloria Johnson, spoke with Gloria Johnson several times. We've had really good conversations. Gloria Johnson was someone who had worked with special needs kids, made a career out of that. She had made a career out of being an educator. She cared about people in our part of the world. She cared about what they were going through. She had ideas and policies that would have helped Tennessee tremendously. But people in this part of the world were taught to believe, well, she's a Democrat, though. Well, you know, I don't meet people that loves Marsha Blackburn and thinks Marsha Blackburn is a great person necessarily. When I've traveled into Kentucky playing music and politics has came up, I've never really heard anyone say, oh, man, Mitch McConnell is such a great guy. What they will say to you is, at least they ain't a Democrat. So going forward, we're going to have to figure out a way, and I'm not telling you that I have the answer yet. I'm humble enough to admit that I don't fully have the answer. But as we're going forward, we're going to have to point out to them that we do have their best interest at heart. And maybe if Donald Trump has unchecked power for the next couple of years and they feel the effects of what's happened, then maybe we can turn a corner. And it may not happen in our lifetimes, but I would love to see the day where people are saying, well, shit, you know, at least they weren't Republican. At least they weren't MAGA. At least they weren't a descendant of Donald Trump's madness, because that's where we're going to have to get to. And there's going to be a lot of people who will say, well, you can't start calling them racist, and you can't start saying they went to a Nazi rally, and you can't start saying, well, when they do those things, we're still going to call them on it, because we cannot let hate win. We cannot let hate win. And to the people out there who said, I didn't vote for Trump because I'm a racist, that's not what it was. Because I'm homophobic or transphobic, that's not what it was. It was just for policy or whatever. In order for us to be able to come together, you're going to have to say out loud, you're going to have to denounce the racism. You're going to have to denounce the hatred. You're going to have to denounce the hateful rhetoric. Because as long as Donald Trump is your mouthpiece, he's spreading hatred. He's pushing it to people who, in these hate groups, they're now more amplified and more empowered than ever. Those are the people that he energizes. We could be having a whole lot of good conversations right now. We could be sitting here talking with someone on the opposite side of the aisle having a really productive conversation. But when you've got a guy standing up going, get him out of here, get the son of a bitch off the field, we're going to send him home, they're poisoning the blood, they're the enemy from within. That is riling up the Nick Fuenteses and the Alex Joneses of the world. That's getting them empowered. And as long as they're loud, we have no choice but to call it out. And if you get offended because we're calling it out, it says everything about you that you're not. So we tried to warn them. We tried to show them. We brought the receipts. We brought the evidence. We brought the truth. We showed it to them right in front of their face. They still didn't buy it. If someone has solutions as to how we get through to people, because I just feel like one of the people that was sitting back calling into my brother at Jonestown going, hey, don't drink the Kool-Aid. And then waking up to the devastation that followed. But folks, I want to thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. We did lose some subscribers on election night, but we've already doubled it and it's came back, or I guess maybe some new people are coming to the channel. So if you're new to this channel, I want you to know that I always want my platforms to be a place where people can come and feel safe, and we can discuss ideas, we can discuss opposing ideas in a respectful way, and we can move the conversation forward. And I welcome anyone's suggestions as to how we do that. Unless you're a racist, over-the-top, homophobic asshole, and then you have no seat at my table, plain and simple. But thank you for hitting that subscribe button. If you haven't already, be sure to leave a comment if you feel like it. I know everyone's feeling down, but hey, leave a blue heart and let me know you're hanging in there and you're doing okay. And I love you, and we will continue to work to get through this.